If you knew that was going to happen, if you knew that, you know, that guy in the orange shirt would end up like that.
Oh, uncle, how are you? How are you? Good, good, good. God bless you. God bless you. Preach, preach, uncle, preach.
Yes. This gentleman says that I'm preaching Surah Bakra, but I don't need to preach Surah Bakra. I am here to preach Jesus Christ. Yeah. Who is your Lord? Who is my Lord?
Allah. Allah. All Lord. All of our Lord.
Your Lord is Allah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
I'm Muhammad.
Okay. Who is Allah? Who is Allah?
God. One who created you, the one who created me, the one who created all this.
Are you sure?
I am positive.
Are you sure?
I'm 100%. 10%.
Okay. Now tell me, who was the father of Muhammad?
Abdullah.
Yeah.
That's his uncle.
What does Abdullah mean?
Slave of Allah.
Slave of Allah.
Yeah.
Abdullah means the slave of Allah. Yeah. But Abdullah was born in pagan family. He lived as a pagan. He worshipped pagan Allah. So which Allah servant he was? Which Allah servant he was? So clearly it says that he was the servant of pagan Allah.
Pagan Allah?
Yeah. He was the servant of pagan Allah. So if Muhammad's father is the servant of pagan Allah, then who is your Allah? Who is your Allah? Your Allah is a pagan god like Muhammad. Your Allah is a pagan god like Muhammad, because Muhammad worship pagan Allah. Muhammad worship pagan Allah. His father worship pagan Allah. And all the Muslims, they are the follower of Muhammad.
You believe Jesus is God?
Do I believe Jesus is God?
He's God then.
Even Quran, even Quran says that Jesus is the very word.
The word of Allah.
Receive by Mary. And that word's name is Jesus. That word's name is Jesus.
Jesus is the son of God. So how can he be God?
Exactly.
So how much
are you following your own Bible?
Let me show you from the Bible and from the Quran.
Okay. That's fair, that's fair. Let's go to the Quran first. Quran first, uncle. Let's fact check.
Can you read this for me, please?
Arabic. Yeah. Read it.
Come on, go ahead and read. You're the in English, please.
You're the preacher.
Read this in Arabic and in English.
Okay.
Let me tell you the summary of this verse.
Why is the summary of this
verse? Gabriel is coming to Maryam. Yes?
Alright.
Am I right or wrong?
Yeah,
Gabriel is coming to Maryam.
Yes.
And bringing a word.
Glad tidings.
A word. And that word is Isa ibn Maryam.
Yeah.
That word is Isa ibn Maryam.
How does that prove that Muhammad was such a pagan?
But my friends and my children, Bible is written way before Quran.
Yeah.
Way before Quran.
Yeah.
John chapter 1.
Don't speak about John. Wait, and
John chapter 1, verse 1 says. Listen carefully. Listen carefully. Listen carefully, please.
Don't speak about John. John is.
John chapter 1, verse 1 says. In the beginning was word, and the word was with God. And the word was God.
John was 40 years after Jesus died.
The word became flesh and lived among us.
John was 40 years after Jesus died.
Who is that word?
So Isa.
According to Quran.
So Isa is the word of Allah.
Isa is the word.
Isa
is the word.
So it's eternal.
I know you shared that at Liverpool. Jesus was God.
Jesus is God according to Quran.
According to the Quran.
I have. I have just now proven it. I have just now proven it.
This is the
word of
God.
This is the very word came to Maryam.
Yeah. You just said that Jesus is the word of God, and I see that Jesus is God.
The word.
Yeah, but it's the word eternal, though.
Jesus in the beginning is the word, but Jesus.
But the Bible is written way before Quran. Way before Quran.
Yeah, but Jesus is not the
beginning. Ask him if it's eternal.
How is John pure? It was written 60 years after Jesus had died. How is it pure?
Sorry.
Every other gospel was written at the time of Jesus. But John was written 60 years after Jesus died. How can it be pure?
What is not pure?
John, Gospel of John.
Gospel is. Gospel of John is not pure?
It's corrupted.
It's corrupted. Oh,
are you saying? Are you saying that Allah's Quran is corrupted?
What's the number one rule of Christianity?
That Allah's Quran is corrupted?
What's the number one rule of Christianity? Come on, man. Read your brain.
See?
Read your brain.
No.
What's the number one rule of
Christianity? You are insulting your Allah.
Yeah, yeah. Why?
Allah is the one who gave this Anjil. And Torah, Zabur. Allah is the one who gave this Torah, Zabur, and Anjil. You are insulting your Allah. You are insulting your Allah. This cannot be changed. This cannot be changed. Bible cannot be changed. That is eternal.
Did Jesus write the Bible?
Eternal word of God.
Did Jesus write the Bible?
That is eternal.
Jesus wrote the Bible.
Jesus wrote the Bible.
Yeah.
Jesus,
how can it be pure?
The very word of God.
How can the Injil be pure if Jesus didn't write it?
Jesus is the very word of God.
Did Muhammad write the Quran?
No, not at all.
Was he not illiterate?
No.
Was he not illiterate?
Muhammad.
Love your neighbor as yourself. I love my neighbors here.
We love
the Muslims.
These are my neighbors, and I love them. He looks like he loves us. One at a time.
Let me ask you a question.
Yes.
How did Jesus pray?
How did Jesus pray?
Our Father.
He said, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Jesus.
That's your answer.
Answer the question.
Yes.
Not what did he say, how did he pray?
How did he pray?
Yeah. He prayed in prostration, right?
No.
Many prostrations.
Next question.
Let me show you Jesus. Let me show you how Jesus prayed.
So he prayed, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So if Jesus was God, why did he pray to himself?
Come on, let me ask you a question, please. What's the first commandment?
Love God with your all heart.
No, that's not the first commandment.
Are you talking about the Mosaic law?
No, no, that's the, no.
Are you talking about the Ten Commandments?
It says in your Bible.
Or are you talking about the new law Jesus has given?
What is the greatest
Jesus has given a new law. Are you talking about that?
You people don't even know your own.
Are you talking about the new law Jesus has given?
Commandment. It's pointless talking to you.
I'll teach you.
You don't know the first commandment.
Stay.
No.
Don't kill and run. Don't kill and run.
No, you answer my question first, properly. You
have a question. Can I answer your question?
No.
I'll beg you. I answer your question.
No, listen.
What's the first commandment? Give me the right answer, please.
First commandment. I'm gonna answer.
Let me.
The Bible.
First commandment comes when man and woman was in the garden with the God. God said,
please just answer this.
Listen.
No, I'm not listening to no lecture. I want a straight answer.
Listen,
I'm going.
I asked for the
question.
What's the first commandment?
Don't do a shanty.
First commandment
was
in paradise.
What's the first commandment?
Listen, I am asking.
What's the first commandment?
Listen.
I'm not listening to no lecture.
Did you lift your ears at all?
No.
Because I'm answering the question.
You're not answering
the question is, yeah.
I'm not asking you when
he
was revealed.
I'm asking you what the first commandment took place.
I'm asking you what the first commandment.
Yeah.
Come on, answer me.
God made man and woman. God turned to man and woman and then said, do not eat from this tree. That is the first commandment.
No, it's not.
Jesus,
no,
what is the greatest commandment?
Ten commandments.
No, you're saying
worship one God. Worship
you're
one
lying.
God. This is in the Bible.
Show me.
You're calling me a liar.
Yeah.
That's right.
No, we come on.
You believe that.
Of course,
you
believe that.
Because
the Lord your God is one God. We believe that.
Exactly, one God.
We believe that.
Number one.
What's the second commandment?
Like a number.
What's the second commandment?
Why are you asking? Do you even have that?
Read it for you.
No, what's the second commandment?
Do you want me to read it?
No, you don't.
You believe in the Quran. You believe in the Bible, so I'm asking
you. You don't have this in Quran.
No, we have this.
No, you don't.
Let me just explain. Sir, are you okay?
Yeah,
he's a fan. He's a fan.
He's famous.
He's a fan of you.
I don't want to be a fan of you. Please be a fan of me.
Honestly,
no disrespect.
You people don't know your
own religion. Don't do a shamsi. Come on, bro. Hey, we're going to give you the answers. Don't do a shamsi.
Don't run like a coward.
Don't
run like a coward person.
With all your heart,
come here.
With all your mind, with all your soul.
Amen.
And
amen.
Love your neighbor.
Amen.
I find that amazing.
Yeah.
That's not first commandment, as well as not the greatest commandment is in the Quran.
Ah, what's the greatest commandment?
Anyone can tell me why it is not in the Quran?
Yeah, that's a good question. Any Muslims?
Yeah. Are you Muslim?
Come Muslim, answer.
You're not Muslim.
He's a Muslim. He's a Muslim.
You are Muslim?
Yeah, come on.
Do you want to sit on my chair?
That's right.
You don't want to see that.
Be nice.
You're going to fall on the floor.
I find that amazing that you think it's funny.
It was funny. Yeah, it was very funny.
Of course, that's a deed. But let me ask you the basic question.
All right.
I feel right now, I really need to, you two as a Muslim to justify for me. Why do you believe Muhammad is the prophet of God?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Well, that's a good question.
Do you believe Muhammad is the prophet of God?
Why? Give me your best reasons.
So I have to answer to you. Oh, sorry. No, don't answer. Don't include me in your conversation.
You don't want to be included in the conversation.
I just wanted to see you.
Why?
Because your voice. I just love your voice.
Why don't you want to be included in the conversation?
Because you cannot answer the basic question. No, I can't.
You can't. Let me ask you questions which has nothing to do with the Islamic doctrine.
All right.
Would you have sex with a child?
Sorry?
Would you have sex with a child?
No.
Why this man thought it was alright to have sex with a child?
You tell me.
You're Muslim, educate me. So you are following a man who thought it was alright to have sex with a child.
Yeah.
Wow.
But you think it is not alright to have sex with a child?
No.
Contradicting.
So you wouldn't have sex with a child, but you are following someone who taught, not only he taught,
he had
sex with a child, and then he told all of his followers, really? Please go and do it, it's lovely!
Where?
Verse 4.
Show me.
And not only that, I'll also give you lovely customs of Muhammad.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Give us one, please. Hatun, I want to learn. Hatun.
You want to learn? You don't want to learn that. Because once you learn that, if you are Muslim, you give up Islam.
Yeah.
If you are Christian or if you are not believer, yeah, you look at the children. Sorry, if you are not believer, you look at the children and all in your mind, lots of lust freaks out. All sky turns with the hearts. Why? Because you just learned you can have sex with a child.
That's disgusting.
I know it is disgusting, but I am not Muhammad.
Look at this.
I am not Muhammad.
Look at this.
Let me see, brother.
10 years old girl. And
so,
more than 55 year man.
Sir.
Evidence. Oh, evidence. Fact check, please.
You are Sunni Muslim?
What?
Are you Sunni Muslim?
Sunni Shia.
So, first reference is India. Please read with me. My English is not very good.
Narrated by Aisha.
All the right. Prophet, yeah. And I used to take part from one single quote that called Quran. Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 250. A man who is in 50s thinks he can have part with a child and he fondles a child. But let's get on with the basics. Aisha reported. Sir, are you listening?
No, sorry.
You are not listening?
No, sorry. I just wanted a picture of you. Sorry.
He is no more Muslim. He is no more Muslim.
Yeah, she's my sister.
She's your sister?
Yeah.
Would you be okay if your brother has a sex with a child?
No.
Would you be okay if the man who he thinks this is the best example to humanity has sex with a child? I don't think you need to smile to that. That's very ugly.
I'm not asking.
Please be unshine and share the information. I'm asking how, as a woman, you would feel that your brother thinks it's all right that he puts his eternity on someone who thinks it's all right to have a sex with a child when he's in his 50s. No, that's ugly, isn't it? But let's hear Aisha. Muslims don't care what you say. He wouldn't care what you say. Everyone would care. One of the best Muslim scholar woman Aisha says to humanity.
Okay.
And Aisha, mother of believers.
Yeah, mother of believers. That child girl,
She's been
Aisha reported that Allah's... Yeah, I am liar. I am reading from Sahih Muslim. Allah's apostle married her when she was 7 years old. She was taken into his house as a bride when he was 9. And her dolls were with her. Most reliable person after Muhammad, mother of the believers, Aisha tells you in Sahih Muslim, volume 8, hadith number is 3311. Your prophet had sex with a child and please walk away. I know it is disturbing.
I know it's embarrassing. Yes.
And even visualizing it is disturbing. Can you see this man,
yes,
who is identified? This is not, of course, not exactly him. Probably he's not as this handsome. That's not funny, Jason. This man thought it was alright to have sex with a child. That's of course not enough.
Disgusting.
He practiced it and that wasn't enough. He told in Surah 65 verse 4 his followers to practice that.
Wow.
Would you do that, brother?
No, never.
But 1.6 billion people follow Muhammad and they want to do it.
Wow. Disgusting.
This is an opportunity for them to do.
Are they sure?
They are.
If they know it, what
is this gentleman is aware of it now. This gentleman is aware of it.
He's against it, by the way. He's against it.
He's against it, but he's aware of it. He's still following a prophet who practice it very much disturbing.
That's why he's running away.
And it becomes more disturbing when you simply stay silent and be okay about it and pretend you never heard of it.
Okay. Abdul, leave Islam.
Sorry if you thought Muhammad wasn't handsome.
Leave Islam, bro. It's embarrassing. Rapper was in the rap up.
Yeah, that was rapper.
Praise the Lord.